Hello and welcome to Cosplayers React to Miraculous Ladybug. This week we are watching Time Tagger, which is one that you guys requested. I'm Hilda Glitz, I play Chloe in the 86th Floor cosplay music videos.
I'm Rascal Rabbit, I play Adrian and Cat Noir.
And I'm Luminar and I play Marinette and Ladybug.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Ooh, small children, you know what that means, Momo? You know who can't be far behind?
Don't do this. I was just gonna harmlessly observe, is that the Cesare twins?
Yeah, it's Ali's little sisters.
Cool. And then Nino's little brother. They're wearing kind of matching outfits in different colours.
It's very cute.
That's very powerful. Rise and shine when I pick up the mic, like this game is mine. Fake MCs can't test my flow, cause I whip up the beep with each word I throw.
The name's Marinette. I bake shoe kits. I love. This is very cursed. I forgot that they did the little rap battle.
I don't like
for a second
it.
I thought she was just like recording for her personal SoundCloud, and I think maybe Nino got her into SoundCloud.
Nino was like, yo babe, I need a vocalist for my sick beats, would you be that vocalist? And Ali was like, yes of course.
Shoot, I'm so bad at this game.
What's up? You don't want to play with my sisters anymore?
I'm not a baby anymore. Can I play Freestyle Clash 2 with you?
Come on.
Can I freestyle rap with you guys?
He's like, I'm not a baby anymore, sir. You are this big.
That literally, look so how small he is.
Yeah, and also, and think Alia. About...
And like, compare those to an adult in Paris. So you are tiny.
Yeah, I was gonna say I really hate the kind of, well, again, the Sims logic of the scaling in this is that teenagers have to come up to their like adults' elbows, and then children have to come up to teenagers' elbows, and I'm like, that is not how big teenagers or children are.
The elbow.
His head is bigger than like the rest of his entire body.
Yeah. Big brained.
These three on your own. I just remembered I promised my dad I would try out his new macaroon recipe.
Sounds yummy. Maybe we could all come over and try it out with you if that's okay.
Oh yeah, I mean...
Shout out to Alia for going, if that's okay. Because so many people in this show just invite themselves around to places that they weren't invited. They never ask.
The excuse wasn't exactly your best one yet, Marinette. I know.
Oh my god, Tiki!
Tiki, step off!
Get off of your high horse and stop judging for 1 second, I'm begging.
Absolutely killed. At least she's making excuses and like doing the right thing, Tiki.
Yeah, Tiki, god.
Cat Noir, if you don't give me your miraculous, this pigeon iron will crash down on the Louvre Pyramid and give all the tourists inside it perfectly flat socks.
Perfectly flat socks?
I can't even try and unpack that one, mate. Yeah.
I don't get it.
One of Mr. Pigeon's many outings. Do you think that the reason that he gets akumatized so much is not actually because he's mad at pigeons all the time, but he's actually like a mate of Gabriel's? Like they like go out to lunch and Gabriel's like, don't worry, mate, like you can have your little power trip. Like you're helping me out.
I'll hook you up.
I'll hook you up.
No need to brief you on this one, right?
Nope. Let's just end this fast like the last 23 other time.
23!
This is part of the proof. He's literally just out there all the time.
That's so
crazy.
Cat Noir looks so cute here. Like, he looks so defeated.
This is the exact look that my cat gives me when she's like cuddled up having a nap and I walk in and she's like, you dare wake me by being in the same room. Like,
just the sadness.
Lucky charm.
The utter defeat.
I love this mundaneness. I love like them just being bored of their powers and just being like, let's just do it, you know.
I love stuff like that. Like I love like seeing like a very like slice of life, like it's not all like epic fights, right?
Going
sometimes it's
emotions.
Just boring.
Sometimes it's just Mr. Pigeon again.
We live in a society.
We live in a society.
This really says a lot about our society.
This is some biting satire about the world in which we live.
Bye bye, little butterfly.
Please don't tell me it happened again.
It's okay, Mr. Romney. We'll always be here to bring...
Again, this is what we were saying about the scaling here. Ladybug and Cat Noir come up to his shoulder. And so that therefore means that that kid, like Nino's little brother, comes up to like his shin.
I don't like it.
We keep getting better at this. We have a few minutes before we transform.
That's sweet. I mean, like, we're getting better, so we've got more free time.
I also love the concept of like Cat Noir counting down the minutes he's got to eat his ice cream and just like munching real hard and getting brain freeze.
Yeah, Cat Noir would definitely be the kind of person who'd bite his ice cream.
Oh, absolutely.
I hate to say it, but he is.
Why not?
I'm really sorry.
There we go. What did I tell you?
We know this boy too well.
He's an ice cream biter. He's one of those people.
Literally, everyone else still has the ice cream and he has inhaled his.
Kumatized him 24 times and not once has he come close to succeeding.
Right, Hawkmoth, do you think that maybe now that's not the time to like take the L and stop?
Like, I've akumatized him 24 times and it's not working.
It's a bit embarrassing.
I don't get it.
What is that? There's that expression where they're like, the definition of madness is doing the same thing again and again and yeah, expecting different results.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
I'm Time Tiger from the future, man. I crisscross time with a spray paint can. Looks like your time's up at last, because I'm going to send you way back to the past.
Right.
It's the way we pause, but none of us have anything to say.
Yeah.
Imagine that happening to you. Like, if a portal was opened,
and somebody came through with some mediocre rap
and some blue snazzeru on.
What would you do?
I would simply exist. I would simply stop existing.
I would simply stop existing.
What? Okay, so obviously I know this is the whole concept of the episode, but I love this idea that like that people get sent back in time and for some reason everyone who gets sent back in time has made like really made something of themselves. Yeah. So it like gives them a statue.
Only 1 minute left.
No time to lose.
I mean, you could just go back and recharge, couldn't you?
Yeah, but they're seeing that people are being sent back into the past and, you know,
yeah, but
duty
they know
calls.
That, they know that Ladybug's gonna miraculous Ladybug it, right? It's still gonna be fine.
It'll be fine, just like she did in the New York special.
All I have to do is go back in time to escape with a laugh and a rap and rhyme.
He's traveling through time.
Therefore, in space.
What? That's Cat Noir. There's something about season 3 Cat Noir zingers that just are so like, they miss every time. Their comments made in a zinger tone.
I just love his style.
I'm not so-
I just love his style.
I just think he's cool.
I just think he's cool. Why is he posed like that?
In the future, you and Ladybug still know each other.
Yeah, but if I want the chance to see that future, we're gonna have to defeat Time Tiger today. Plague, clock out!
Okay, I love that the advice was you still know each other. You haven't had an epic falling out and don't speak anymore.
It's like, hey, she's not sick of you, Adrian.
Crazy! So the message was for real. What message? This watch has been in my family since forever.
Oh my god, here we go. Right, so when we did our Timebreaker reaction, way back when we still could be in the same room, unfortunately, we recorded that literally a week before this episode came out. So we were all sat there going, oh, what's this? Why is this watch so important? What's going on?
What is that? Who is their ancestor?
And then like a week later, this episode dropped and suddenly we were like, we were right. It wasn't just like a weird hologram thing. Like, it's a bloomin' miraculous and we've been new. I felt so validated.
The Egyptian collection. My old man says some of it dates back more than 5,000 years.
Oh, we're back. We're back in here. We're back
here we go again.
I love Night at the Museum.
Right, this is just violating all kinds of security issues.
That's not allowed.
You can't. Well, I guess she's wearing gloves.
She is wearing gloves, but the idea is they're not gloves that she's been wearing and sort of sweating in and been punching supervillains with and dragging them all over the floor outside and.
Do your thing, kitty.
Cataclysm.
Okay,
right, I'll take it back.
Yeah, we should have reserved our judgment for what Adrian was about to do. Wow, just destroying ancient artifacts
anywhere.
No worries. It's also the fact that they weren't even sure. Like, she was like, "This one kind of sounds hollow. Go for it." Imagine if nothing was in there, and they were like, "Boom."
She's just chilling in there, huh?
I love her.
You know what? When anyone asks us, like, what character from Miraculous would you cosplay if it wasn't the ones that we currently do? Why did I never say Bonix? Her design is amazing.
I could so see you as Bonix.
Yeah!
Minibug, Kitty, I knew you'd solve my riddle.
That's so cute. She calls Minibug and Kitty. How cute.
Well, she does come up to what?
The elbow height thing again. Yeah. God's sake. This is what makes me really mad, right? Is Alex is what, like 14? Probably Alex hasn't got a lot more growth in her, but this isn't how height works. So like Bunnix, like this is adult Alex, right? And Alex is like what, like 4'9" right now? People who are 4'9" when they are 14 don't suddenly become 5'9". Like, that's just not possible. I'm sorry.
In the future, I'm a member of Ladybug and Cat Noir's team of superheroes. Well, the Ladybug and Cat Noir you're going to become, because right now...
Okay, I know that this is all exposition and we keep pausing it to talk about things that then get, like, revealed, but the idea of there being, like, a...
Justice League.
A Justice League, but, like, a proper one, rather than the one they do in season 3 where they're like, oh, guest of the week is Retta Rouge. Yeah. Like a proper established kind of Avengers or Justice League style team is...
You two are more like Minibug and Kitty Noir. Within the team, I am the hero of the last chance. I'm called upon when everyone else has failed. That includes you two.
I'm the insurance plan.
Why would you brag about that? Would you be like,
it makes it makes your team look awful as well. Where it's like, yeah, they got a call on me when it's all gone absolutely pear-shaped.
Yeah, presumably she does this a lot.
You must have failed somewhere too.
Yes, well, no. It was actually your fault. Or more precisely, it will be. In the future, one of your cataclysms will accidentally damage my Miraculous.
Whoa, that's a lot to put on him, being like, oh, sorry, mate.
Wait, then how are we gonna do that without the rabbit Miraculous? Do you have the watch? My watch? Yes, my watch, our watch.
This must be like pretty mind-bending for Alex.
I was just gonna say, like, imagine just seeing like the older you, who's like got all of this responsibility and power, like on top of the fact that you're talking to another version of yourself.
That's
like,
nuts, yeah.
So this was a Miraculous in camouflage mode. Fluff, counterclockwise.
Oh my god, Alex, this is so cool. Look at her.
So I want to cosplay
that outfit.
That is so... I just love the little rabbit.
This has
so
like
much.
Vaguely 2000s energy, but I mean that in a good way.
Yeah, no, you're so right. It's the shorts and tights for me.
It's the shorts and tights, but also like the pink, black, and green, like sporty color combo.
I'm gonna get a Miraculous. So cool.
Hell yeah, cowabunga, dude!
I'm so scared.
The bunny is adorable.
It's like with rabbit body language, right? When a rabbit's ears are like pinned all the way back, it means it's really happy. I don't know what all the way forward means. I don't think that's possible.
That Miraculous seems so powerful. How come we don't use it more often?
That's a good question, Carol. Oh,
it's
hell
so
yeah.
Cute.
The pockets, the color scheme, the umbrella, We love to see it. Also, I love the boots that have like a gentle heel, but not like a stupid wedge heel.
They're practical.
Like, they're practical, but they're stylish.
Guys, you should take a look at this now.
Time Tagger sent Jagged Stone into the...
Not the Bard, Jagged Stone.
This is like, you know, like the Bard core remixes of songs. It's
like... Jaggeth Stone.
That's Nadia Shamak.
Don't be bemused, it's just the ye olde news.
Don't be bemused, it's just the morning scroll.
Not Andre going back to ancient Egypt. Like,
Andre.
He's made it work for himself. He's become a well-respected ice cream peddler.
You will be an awesome team leader, the greatest superhero ever. How do you explain Time Tagger then? I told you earlier, if Cat Noir hadn't cataclysmed my miraculous, Time Tagger wouldn't be here.
So basically what she's saying is, you're great, Ladybug. You're going to be so good. Like, you're just the best leader. Cat Noir, liability. Ditch him as soon as possible.
That's just like, it's so sad. And like, that if this was like a Cat Noir-centric episode, this would like really weigh on his psyche. And he'd probably be like, I am a really terrible superhero. Like, but you know, no. None of that.
He's had enough
time to weave a giant time web around us.
Surrounded by just one guy?
Yeah, it's because you spent ages in the toilet and Cat Noir, you were faffing around asking about your love life. Like...
Stay right there, okay? Then it'll be exactly like it was in my memory. And now... Burrow!
I love this power that she has. This time portal power.
I love how to everybody else it just looks like she's like, right, okay.
Bye.
Up, Alex. I'm going to head out.
All right, bye. I'm going to just head out.
She doesn't need to transform back before she uses her power again?
No, because she's an adult.
Awesome. I can't wait to grow up.
I can't wait to grow up and have endless destruction power.
Endless destruction.
Mood.
Alex that is was very slick. Cool. Alex is very cool.
That was slick. There's a little bit of a Kingsman sort of choreography
yes!
here. You know
it's the umbrella.
I mean?
My victory is close at hand. How brilliant of me to send myself such a powerful ally from the future.
Hormoth just sitting back, relaxing, reaping the
he
rewards.
Really is,
right. Well, hold on. Here is like, so. Ladybug and Cat Noir are a bit rubbish in this episode because they're children, but like, because they're from the past. But like, what's Hawkmoth's excuse? Like, he's an adult in this time period and the future one.
Thing is, though, if I was Hawkmoth at the moment and I had a glimpse into the future many years, I realized I'm still at it. I'd be having a bit of a think right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, but it's not him though, is it? We haven't had that little bit of info yet, but he doesn't know that this isn't his work. Like, this is someone else.
I was under the understanding that he was informed somehow that he was still doing this later on.
I think what he misunderstood was that Hawkmoth is still around in the future,
okay. But
Hawkmoth doesn't necessarily mean Gabriel as Hawkmoth, so he has assumed that Hawkmoth means it's still him, and for some reason that hasn't made him go, I need to change up my
I was
going to
say, from that perspective, if I were him, I'd be having to sit down and think right now.
Yeah, like, I'd be like, I really need to rethink my plan, mate.
Like, I can't stand watching him play cat and mouse like this. Cataclysm!
Bro. For God's sake, this is literally what she just was like, your badly timed cataclysm ruined everything. And what does he do? Badly timed cataclysm.
Enjoy your trip to the Ice Age, Fluffy Tail.
Back to the Cretaceous then. To the future, 7th Interstellar War.
7th Interstellar War? Excuse me?
I
feel like putting her in like the Ice Age from the Cretaceous period. It's quite different to just like plunging her into a war zone. That's quite mean.
The heat is on.
What? Where did she go?
So he, you know, the little numbers that flash, yeah. He sent her back to 79 AD.
Or, oh, okay. Which is, I was wondering what they were.
Oh! Oh no!
I wasn't clocking that the numbers meant anything. I thought he was just like getting 4 points.
The numbers of the year he's sending them to. And so yeah, it was 79 AD. Oh my god. Thank you, Beth, for being our resident history buff.
Also, I realised I said the eruption of Pompeii, which is not what happened. It was Vesuvius that erupted.
Oh, yes, but Pompeii didn't perish.
Don't worry about it.
You always think of something.
Fair enough, Ladybug. Wish granted.
Be careful, it could be a trap.
If she thinks she can trick me, she's...
Almost like, don't do this, mate. Lucky Charm works in mysterious ways. Don't just give her this.
Almost like, no, I've been burned by this before. I think it's a trap.
Time's up. My moment of victory has arrived.
God, Marinette's very smart. Like, we roast her, but she is quite smart. I wouldn't work this out.
Come on, man, that's not enough time to write a letter.
Yeah, bro.
She's only got the first, like,
dear future me. Oh, that's all.
Imagine, obviously we know that Ladybug knows what she's doing here, but, like, the vibes for everyone else must be so awkward right now.
Yeah.
Time tagger, just being like, right, yeah, go for it. Just write a letter to your future self. And you just kind of like,
go back to your time stream, Bunnix. Make the most of your remaining time. Trust me.
Bro.
Come on, Cat Noir. We better give him our miraculous.
Yeah, don't take her hand. Oh, take her
hand. Oh, no, wrong one.
Oh, yeah. I was about to roast him for, like, what if you'd taken her hand with the wrong one, but the fact that they're holding hands is just really cute, so.
Very sweet.
Sorry, Ladybug.
Oh, some silhouettes! And that's all we get. That's all we get.
Yeah, the silhouettes are exactly the same designs as their current ones.
Yes, they are exactly the same designs. Very good. And we don't see anything else. So that's good.
I didn't deliver. Not true, Bunnix. You didn't fail.
Oh, but they have pitched down Christina V's voice.
Yes.
Or she's just doing a lower voice than usual.
Every problem has a solution.
God, that's very impressive that she managed to map that out accurately in the time she was given from standing over there. Like, mate.
Feels good.
The future bird catches the worm. This time, the miraculous...
future bird catches the worm.
You know,
now we see where Cat Noir gets his bad zingers from.
It's hereditary.
The miraculous are not for you.
What?
I said I was sent by the Hawk Moth of the future, but I never said the Hawk Moth of the future was you.
Got him!
Got him!
Damn, right. I mean... Right, we've talked about this so many times, but who do we think it is, gang?
I don't know. I'm still on my brain with anything else right now.
It's at full capacity.
So you think it's going to be Sabrina?
Well, I don't think it will be. I would like it to be.
I think it's got to be Leela. Got to be. Yeah. Leela, Lila, I'm really sorry.
I believe it's Lila.
I believe now, after we produced an entire miraculous Zoom skit pronouncing it Leela, I have now been led to believe that it is, in fact, Lila. Sorry, gang.
It's Lila because she's a Lila.
The British pronunciation of Lila. Sorry, guys.
Your earrings are mine.
You're not got anything to say about that, Gabriel. That's a bit... You're not going to go,
who is it?
Because if the answer is, it's that young lady Lila, then Hawkmoth's like, I know her. She's clearly going to be my prodigy, you know, my apprentice. Or if the answer is Felix, your nephew, then he's like, brilliant. I'll make it a family business. I'll bring in Adrian can intern with us. Brilliant. Don't worry about it.
Adrian can intern.
Whereas not telling...
Adrian sat on like a not so good little chair in the corner of the attic taking notes.
Okay, no, but actually, how much does that slap as a potential plot line where Hawkmoth is like, I'm going to train up my son and nephew to be the next Hawkmoth, and Adrian's like, bomb. But then he's like, no, this is good because I've got insider info.
No, it's not good because then every time he's like, right, Adrian, like, I'm going to be on the job tonight. Like, you got to come and like help me out. And he's like, sorry, Dad, I've got to go immediately.
I need to immediately leave.
Having two of them is quite a good thought. Because you could have one who's doing the you know, the villainy, and one who's just going around and upsetting people, creating opportunity.
No, but imagine,
they can swap shifts, you know what I'm saying?
Day shift, well, night shift.
And you, Kitty Noir, cataclysm this so I can take your ring safely after I'm finished with her. Good boy.
I love that future Ladybug and Cat Noir are intervening, but like from the wings. They're like, let's go. Some beat version of the.
Why doesn't anyone tell me how awesome I am?
Because you already.
Probably because you're literally the reason that all of this happened, because you messed up twice. That's so sad. Because.
Yeah, I think she's about to tell him he's awesome.
You're the best, Kitty Noir.
God, the bar's so low, isn't it? She didn't even say he was awesome. She was like, you're the best, Kitty. Bye.
And he's like...
you give him a crumb and he's fed for days. Bye, bestie.
We bugaboo?
Are we going to see each other again soon? No doubt about that.
She's going to say no.
No.
Doubt about that.
No.
No. Hard.
That's not like a pound it. That's just her going to punch her.
No.
No. It. Punch emoji.
Oh, it's so sad. What a sad.
Why am I crying?
Why am I crying?
It's the way he doesn't even have like a parting, like,
he's processing.
I'll get you next time. It's just like a damn, he just wants to resurrect his wife, man.
Master, I
quiet Nero.
It's really sad.
What did he say?
He just went quiet Nero and then what was one? That. He said Nero Darkwing's fall. I don't want to talk about it.
There is something so inherently comical about everything Hawkmoth does, but at the same time, it's just so sad because he just misses his wife.
He just wants his wife back.
I miss my wife, James.
I miss my wife, Nero. I miss her a lot.
If I'm not Hawkmoth in the future, then that means I failed.
Or that you've succeeded. The future is not set in stone, Gabriel.
What was that clinical hug? Like, I will now proceed to give you a hug.
Hey there! Alia, it's Marinette. I'm sorry I won't be able to help you look after Chris and your sister.
Is this allowed? Are you allowed to talk to your friend as Marinette while you're... Never mind.
Alia's like, hey, Marinette, says you're calling... Your call ID is Ladybug right now.
Yeah, that's the Ladybug phone! That's you can't weird. Do that! God's sake.
No biggie. A friend of mine said she'd take care of them, so Nino and I are going to see a movie. A friend? Yeah.
Oh no,
worry.
I forgot about this.
She'll take care of everything.
I forgot about this.
Perfect. Enjoy your movie then.
No fear. The end of this episode, one fear.
I invented Freestyle Clash.
Whoa, for real?
Of course, for real. I never lie.
You're so cool.
Oh no.
You know what's bad though? Is that Alia literally lies to children as well. And she kind of, like, the whole Stormy Weather episode was her being like, yeah, Marinette, when you babysit kids, you've got to just lie to them and then they'll love you. But, you know, when Lila does it...
Oh, it's bad.
Right.
It's bad when Lila does it.
I hated that, right. But think about it. If we're talking about what's his face... The child who's
Chris.
Just become a simp, Chris, in the future, working for Hawkmoth.
We didn't discover it today, but we will next time.
The problem with pigeons in Paris is that they have it too hard here. Maybe you should...
You've literally got... In the previous shot, he had a mouthful of ice cream. Like, he was
swallowed it, man.
Well, he has this shot. His mouth.
Or try to make friends with some other type of animal. Like the next show.
Mr. Rat! very Ratatouille energy going on here. Mr. Pigeon, of course, now is going to become Monsieur Rat.
Yeah, this is true.
Very good.
Aww, look at Bonnet in this.
That's so good. What? All right.
I love her.
All right, so that was Time Tagger. This definitely broke everyone's brains when it came out. I feel like we're very late to the party. You know, you guys know this by now, and thank you for being patient with us. But now I think we've got a bit more context of, like, you know, time travel is like a well-established thing in the Miraculous universe. Well, when I say well-established, we know that there are at least two Miraculouses that do it, but it's still unclear as to how this all works, really. I love Bunnix so much. I'm very excited about the future Ladybug and Cat Noir. I really hope we get to see them at some point properly in the show and not just sort of vaguely silhouetted. I think that would be cool.
I hope all the fan art used to have, like, older Cat Noir had, like, some kind of ponytail.
Treasure Planet sort of look.
Older Ladybug always has, like, a pixie cut, which I really like.
I want that. Because we saw their outfits, but we specifically didn't see their hair. So maybe.
Maybe. We hope. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you get notified when we upload new videos. Let us know in the comments which episodes we should react to next. We love hearing from you guys, and we have a very long list of the ones that you guys are requesting, and we are getting through them, we promise. Give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and we will see you next time. Bye!
Bye!
All I want is for Ladybug to have some shoes.
Give Ladybug shoes.
Let her have some shoes.
Please.
Shoes.
Give her some shoes.